Right. Hello there. This is going to be a local recording of a Legend of Zelda Link to the Past randomizer. I've been doing a few of these off stream. I don't really trust my internet enough to try streaming this, so I'm just going to make a local recording and then upload it afterwards, and that's what you'll be watching. So, yeah, as you see, I got a few seeds on here. I created a few all at once. It's using version 18, which is currently on a site that's available. Well, it's not really a site, but Dessyreqt does not yet have version 18 up on GitHub. It's still undergoing testing. So 18, it's as far as everyone can tell, it's pretty much stable. It's just got some fixes and other stuff, but it should be available on Dessyreqt's GitHub fairly quickly here. And I've been kind of hooked on the randomizer ever since the Link to the Past tournament started on Speedgaming. Now, if you're not familiar with the Link to the Past randomizer, then you're in for a treat. So, we're going to get this one going here. I just did this seed. This was a nightmare seed. Don't ever play this seed. So, we're going to do this one. And as you can see, I'll be playing this on my SD2 SNES. So, let's see here. And we're off. The seed is bootless until boots. Well, that's real helpful. Arrow upgrade plus 10. Ooh, that could be handy. Yeah, okay, so the randomizer. I have a feeling the game is drowning me out. So, let's try this. Okay. That should be a little bit better. But the randomizer in its current form, I selected normal. So your uncle will always drop the sword. There is another style you can choose called open. And your sword could be anywhere. Any sword could be anywhere. Ooh, a bomb drop right away. Excellent, that's gonna help later. For all intents and purposes, you've heard of Let's Plays. Let's call this a Let's Fail. Ooh, an 8-pack of bombs. I am more than okay with this. The prize pools that monsters can drop have been shuffled around. The only time that the prize packs won't be shuffled is if something that an enemy is supposed to drop, like a key, they will always drop a key. Now, that guard was not supposed to drop a key, specifically. Actually, yeah, he was. The treasure chest also had a key. Wait, I only have one key, though. Well, money. Need money. Bomb upgrade. So I have an extra key, which means that one of the chests in the sewer escape is going to have an item. It's nice having 11 bombs already. You know, this guy is always going to drop the big key because he always has to. So here's Zelda. Let's see here. Got a heart piece. That wasn't the compass. Or was it? It wasn't not the map. I kind of forget where everything is now. It's been that long since I played the original Link to the Past. So I don't quite remember what's what anymore. That's okay. And this is actually just going to be pretty standard up until you get to Sanctuary. You know, the beginning of a game is pretty much always going to follow the same route. Now, unless we chose Open, Open would really be crazy. Ah! As you can see, though, I don't have a shield. Your uncle will no longer always give you the shield. In fact, he never gives you the shield. The shield is an item that is randomly shuffled. You could get it anywhere. It could be in one of the first chests I find later on. It could be in Ganon's Tower. I've had both happen. And I'm sure other runners have too. No treasure chest or drops on this particular room, so we'll just proceed forward. Watch out for snakes! They just hurt there. Alright, so we do have a drop in here. Wow, getting a lot of bomb drops already. Heart piece. Okay, we're good with that. That treasure chest is supposed to have a key. But because of the key that we found earlier, it is now just a random shuffled item. That's two heart pieces we found already. That rat always drops a key. That one on the bottom. Wow, the bomb drops are crazy so far. That's good. Oh, there's a shield. Money and a map. So I've got a shield. I can deflect basic attacks. I need 55 rupees to get the item from the merchant. I'm not going to farm them for money quite yet, because money could be in many places. Another heart piece. That's three. One more, we get an extension. So now we're going to check a few places right away. See what kind of money is available. See what just items in general are going to be available. I max out on bombs, so that doesn't matter. Oh, nice. No bottles, no nets. All right, we're going to take a look in here real quick. This is a the Lumberjack's item. Just 10 arrows. In order to get that item, you have to beat Aghanim and get access to the Dark World proper. And that's when this tree becomes open. Since it's just 10 arrows, we probably don't have to beat Aghanim yet, but, you know, that may or may not be true. Might still have to beat him. 300 rupees. All right. Okay, so I need 100 for the merchant in Kakariko Village. I need 500 for King Zoro. So I need 600 total. At the moment we're done in here, I can't check the pedestal where the Master Sword sleeps. I don't have the Book of Madora. And I don't have the three pendants to grab the sword yet and see what would be there. So I'll just have to come back. Let's see what's in here. More money. That there is a heart. Master Sword just chilling out here in the house. Another heart piece. Wow. Okay. So we got an interesting start so far. Another arrow upgrade. And 10 arrows. Bomb upgrade. Red tunic. Red tunic is surprisingly not as useful as it could be. A lot of things do set damage, so it doesn't protect you from a lot of things. 100 rupee hearts? Okay, not so bad. Or heart piece. Let's see what Chicken House has to offer. You know, anything that does set damage, like rocks falling in Death Mountain. Wow, the 1 rupee. You know, certain fireballs that always do a heart. Those will always do the same amount of damage no matter which tunic you got on. Red, green, or blue. All right, let's hope for a bottle. Hope for a bottle. More money. All right, so Sick Kid's not going to be able to give me anything yet. He'll only give you something when you have a bottle. So we're just going to check around now, see what see what's around, see what we need. Just bombs. Library is not needed. I'm just going to do this thing real quick. Most people just come over here and check to see if they have to. Hopefully it's not complete garbage. ₹300. Okay, so it's not complete garbage. Which means I have enough to go to King Zoro right now. I probably will. But before I do, we're gonna check the light side of the Swamp Palace and see what it's got. Heartbeats. Huh. That's 7, I think. I don't have the mirror, so I can't do the disappearing tile glitch. Might have to come back here. Well, Swamp Palace might have to be a visit later. That's okay. Red rupees? We'll pick it up. Not necessary, but you never know. Alright, so let's see what the Light World Hype Cave has. Oh. Yeah, you can just walk along the bottom here if you're up against the wall and you don't fall down. The things you learn. Money. Another heart piece. More money. Another heart and more money. I think the game is trying to tell me something. Alright, we're off to Zora's Domain. I will come back for the ice cave later. That cave right there is a great fairy. Just get your life refilled. So I can technically defeat Aghanim right now, but it would not really provide anything since the drops in the tower are guaranteed. I believe they're both keys. So, Aghanim. Oh, that's right. I don't have any lifting power. I forget. Alright, so our next stop then, since it's on the way, is going to be the Eastern Palace. At this point, I am not able to complete it, but there's enough chests in there to check to see if it has anything worthwhile. I suppose as long as I'm here, I'm going to check out Sarsaparilla's Cave and, hope one of these items is not trash. Bombos, okay. We'll see if that medallion is needed later. All right, here we are, Eastern Palace. It's a crystal dungeon. Nice. You can tell what music is playing. If it's a pendant dungeon or a crystal dungeon. And this is the song of a Dark World crystal dungeon. So, we're going to see where... What's what? Map? I think that's originally a map. Might be the compass. I don't have a hookshot, so I can't go shortcut to that chest. So, we're going... natural route. Ooh, nice, big key. Alright, let's see what's in this chest. If it's a compass, then the chest to the right is guaranteed to have an item. Just a matter of what it is. Oh, the flute! Nice! Alright, so we'll probably have to exit out of here. Because I have neither a light source or the bow and arrow. And again, drops from pots are still guaranteed. Whatever their prize pools are, or the guaranteed drops themselves. Wow. Okay. That could have gone better. All right, we can save and quit for now. All right, let's yeah. I totally meant to go to Sanctuary. It's okay. This is fine. We're fine. Wow, was that a bee under there? All right, now that we have the flute, the ocarina, we're going to go to Death Mountain. See what the old man has. See what's available up there. If I go to number 2, it places me right in front of the witch. And since I still don't have lifting power, I can't check Zora's Domain. So, first stop, Death Mountain. Gonna go backwards for Grandpa Zelda. That's where he is. You're slow, old man. All right, let's see what he's got. Ouch. Moon Pearl! Nice. I still don't have a mirror, but that actually pretty much signifies that Aghanim probably has to be defeated right now, which sucks. Ouch. It's very likely that we have an Aghanim required seed. What's on top? Lifting power. I don't have a mirror yet, so I can't get up there. A bottle. Okay. We are going to go pick that up. That way I can talk to Sick Kid and Kikariko. And then if he doesn't provide anything useful, I guess we're going to go defeat Aghanim. Let's check desert real quick, see what's down here. Money, okay. Just gonna go check the cave here real quick. And then we'll go Kikariko and then Aghanim. Flippers. Okay. Lake Hylia. I can take the back way into Zora's domain. I did say we were going to check the ice rod spot, but we can wait on that. Famous last words. We'll come back. Up here, we have another bottle. The bottles might be helpful later, but that's kind of out of the way. The bow. Let's see here. I can beat Eastern Palace now. Excellent. All right, let's see what Zora's got. You know, this is something I have never checked, but I wonder if these fairies still give you upgrades, proper upgrades. If they do, then I should get the magical shield, value shield. Nice. still don't have lifting power. Alright, what do we got up here? Cane of Berna. Not useful. I mean, useful, but not really useful. Still, the invincibility might help us. We'll pick it up. Alright, Zora, what do you got? Mirror. Nice. That's a good 500 bucks to spend. That is really good. So, I can technically go to the Tower of Hera right now, but let's, that's a crystal dungeon. Oh, they're all three crystal dungeons. All right. I want lifting power. So, Aghanim is going to have to wait. We might dodge a bullet and not have to fight him. Oh, I meant to go. Wait. Yeah, did I talk to Kakariko Kid? Yeah, I did. Didn't I? No, I didn't. I'll take that. That means I can also complete Eastern Palace. Wait, no, I can't yet. I can't get in there. I don't have the book. I need Titan Smith. Key? I'll probably need that. Mushroom, okay. I have reason to return to the witch. I'll just abuse the damage invincibility. Because I'm on these blue tiles, it's always going to think I'm stuck. So it's just going to give me damage invincibility. Oh, that would have been a nice damage boost. I don't have a torch. Oh, I can't. What a... I can't do anything with this. And since I don't have the big key, I can't get anywhere going up. Okay. I can't really go over here. I don't have a hammer. Alright. Let's see what Ill Kid has. I swear I did this already, but I could have just be remembering incorrectly. Okay, yeah, I didn't. All right. Guess where we get to go? Right back to where we were. If I had bothered to think about that, I would have done that first. But I are the dumb. It's things like that which are just going to cost time. So now that I have a fire source, I can light the lanterns, which means I can also complete Eastern Palace. So I got two crystals coming my way here. Let's see here. Misery Mire is pendant. Palace of Darkness is pendant. Swamp Palace is pendant. This is going to be interesting. Turtle Rock is still 7. There was a race earlier today that is Sunday, April, what's the date? 9th? Where Misery Mire was a pet. Where am I going? Misery Mire was a pendant, but nobody wanted to go in there because it was a pendant. And then when both Razors fought Ganon, it's like, oh, by the way, did you go to Misery Mire and get the light arrows? Both Razors knew how to do Silverless, which is good. Well, hey, I get to do this again. So we'll just chill out and wait for this. Let's see here. I don't have a hammer, so I can't do the back way into the Village of Outcasts. I can't do the front way, because I don't have the Titan's Mitt. It looks like Aghanim initially is going to be required. This will depend on... Oh, nice. This will depend on what Moldorm and Armos drops. Really? Let's see here. I don't have the hook shot, and I suck at bomb jumping, which is to say I can't do it. So we will see what's in Big Chest. Wow, you're not nice. Map, I believe that is vanilla. My health is really good. I don't need a fairy. Titan's Mitts. Okay. Okay. Both gloves right next to each other. That's, you don't really see that too much. I am not upset about that. In fact, I'm very glad, which means I can do Village of Outcasts. Aghanim is now looking like he is not going to be required at all. Oh, you jerk. You jerk, Moldorm. I should have been pointing up. Wow, really? It least this one isn't like his revisit, where if he knocks you down, he knocks you onto spikes. What, did he hit me twice on the way down? That's... What a jerk. Glad I have red mail, because I'm not really taking that much damage. He hits me on the way down. If my health gets in danger, I have fairies as a backup on this upper pit right here. Wow, Moldworm, I'm 0-3 against you. 0-4? I don't know. This is one of those fights where you can get him right away, or he can troll you and it can last for like 10 minutes. Wow, I did that to myself. Legit did that to myself. I'm pretty sure he's not weak to anything else. What are you doing? I don't think so. All right. One down. And all the text for that was removed because it's pointless. All right, let's finish Eastern Palace. Now that I have light source and power lift, power lifting. Wow, you normally see me. I'm surprised you didn't. That's okay, skeletons. He always drops a key. And now it's find the switch. I screwed that up. Screwed it up again. The boots. We are actually getting pretty close to being in go mode here. All right. Hopefully it's not complete garbage. I'm okay with this. Can't really ever not have enough hearts. We can see what medallion we need. We need ether. I have Bombos. Bomb. Bomb upgrade and arrows. A sleeper cave. So I can defeat the boss in here. Actually, no, not yet. I don't have the boss key. I don't have the big key. Hammer. Of course we're gonna get this. Alright, Dark World Exploration is a go. I just need the lantern. Lantern is really the only thing I need now. We'll just get past the book this way. We are going in the front door because we need the big key. And that's not the one I wanted to hit. Alright, first up, let's see what's in this chest. Alright, there's a chance the big key could still be over here. And since I got the key this early, oh, big key right there. Which means if the compass is still up here, piece of heart. That means the pedestal should have the compass. We will go in there to visually confirm it, but I'm pretty sure it's the compass. Bombs. Okay. Actually, that means the big chest is going to have the compass. But we'll check it just to confirm it. This should be the compass. Oh, a map. Okay. I haven't seen the compass yet, which means the compass is on my way. The item down there was just 20 rupees. We do not need to get that. Come on, Link. Don't get stuck. This part will be nice and quick. I was hoping for a magic refill. That's okay. You're gonna have the compass, aren't you? Yeah. That's okay. This is our favorite converging spot. We got quite a few things we can check while we're in here. Let's see here, and I have the fire rod, which means I can complete Skull Woods right now. And it's crystal number 5. Thief Sound is crystal number 2. So I got 2 more crystals I can do right now. Ooh, ether. I can enter Misery Mire. I don't actually need any more money. The chess game is rigged in your favor. The second chest you open will always give you whatever the key item is in that game. Right away. Okay. Thieves' Town has a few chests you can check right away. So even if this is a pendant dungeon, it's still worth coming in here just to check it out. Blue. This is probably a dungeon item. Oh, a key. Still need that key. Which means one of the keys that was down here is no longer. I wonder what's going to be. Ow. Glad I have the red mail so I don't get hurt that badly. Nope. Ow. All right, access to blind. Silly keys. So, as you probably have realized by now, the seed started out very, very slow. But the items have been very kind as of late. You can use the hammer to crush him. I never do. I don't know why. That pot to the left is a bunny thing. Give me hearts. Ew. Don't go in that room on the left. Don't ever go in that room on the left. There's nothing in there except a trap. So, the conveyor is obviously going down, but until Link starts moving there, for whatever reason, the game does not realize that he should be moving down too. Silly game. Really? Wow. That was close. I should have died. Totally should have died. Okay. Before I go to Skull Woods, we're going to check a few treasure chests. Lantern. All right. That means three dungeons, notably Turtle Rock, Palace of Darkness and Misery Mire can now be completed. Well, Misery Mire, because... Wow. Turtle Rock is the only one that's required. Those two might... they might hold something important, but at this point, we're going to say they don't. But rooms that require it will now have some light to them. All right, we're going to check a few items. Let's see here. We have to find the ice rod to complete Turtle Rock. We'll just put this portal down here. I don't have... Okay, I don't have the powder, so I can't check what this bat gives. Pay 10 rupees, get 20 rupees. Yeah, I guess so. I guess so, game. That's harder than it looks. Pressing two buttons at once is hard. Money. Sad. We will come back up to check the digging game. Fun fact, if you have this treasure chest, if you picked up at all and it's not unstuck, or, you know, if it doesn't go back to its spot, digging game is like, hey, you have something following you. I don't like that. Go away. So that is why we cannot do digging game at the moment. We do not care about money. At least we don't have to. Sadly, I don't have the Book of Medora, so I can't check the Bombos tablet. As I was saying, I'm going to check the Bombos tablet. $500 even. Okay, now we're just going to work our way back to digging game. Actually, before we do that, we're going to check our fabled hype cave. This got its name because it's got four items in here, and for reasons, this Well, it's got five items, sorry. Let's see, there's half magic. It just tends to hold good items. Well, we got a piece of heart which filled that up, but generally, you know, half magic, okay, that's a little bit of hype. A little bit of hype. Not too bad. Okay. Digging game. Link, I push the button. And I can actually do Skull Woods at this point, too. This would be funny if I dug up the shovel. This game is RNG hell, this minigame right here. The randomizer changed it, so you are guaranteed to dig up the key item on the 15th dig. Wow, heart piece. Not very random there. And you can tell when you dig up the one item because it'll have that bigger arc. That bigger, longer arc of being discovered. I remember how to go around. That's a bonk. Wow. Alright, let's see what Skull Woods offers. Hopefully something worthwhile. Useless. Full magic refills are always nice. Big key, nice. Alright, plan B. I suck at bomb jumping, so we will take this route in. Wow. Really? That means, the dungeon items are gonna have an item! Hype for that. Always hype for that. Thank you. Wish I had the cane of Samaria. Okay, game. Disagree. Actually, the Cane of Samaria and the Ice Rod are the last two items I need. Map. Alright. I never knew about that skull being there. I always thought it was just another wall. I don't think so, bunny. Oh, wow. How did that rebound hit him? Not bad. Wait, did I ever find the compass? Wait, did I find all three items? Just gonna re-enter real quick to confirm that. Yeah, I did. Okay. Actually, as long as I'm here. And since I finally have the book. We're gonna see if pendants are required. Maxing out the Richter scale is what I do. That is the Quake pendant. Very subtle reference there. Actually, it's not so subtle, but I think I wanted to go back to the light world. All right. We want to We're going to check a few items. Oh, actually, what I can do, and I'm going to have to do that real quick. Oh, it's up here. This will tell me right away if I actually have to get that Quake medallion. I should have come in here from the Dark World. I am such... I am dumb. And the reasoning for this is I can check the King's Tomb, Light and Dark World versions of that area. I can actually see what's up here, too. Alright, what do we got up here? Hearts. Don't need the heart. To get that item, you must have the hook shot and the magic cape. Or you need to be really good at hovering and have the magic cape. No way around needing getting the magic cape. You know, if I'm coming in and it's helpful, then I'll pick it up. We're gonna see what Angry Catfish has. I'm already in the area. I know that's a warp spot, but this puts me closer. I didn't forget about it. What are you talking about? Let's see if I get trolled. Fitting. Oh, that's not the item. That's what I want. Alright. I don't have the hook shot, so I can't do traditional Eastern Death Mountain yet. So we're gonna have to go the long way around. And this will let me see if I have to do Mire, Swamp, and Palace of Darkness. I really hope I don't. Because then I'll have to do all the dungeons. Money up here. Okay, useless. Now, earlier today on stream, during one of the randomizer races, it was mentioned... Oh, shit. I have to do all three. That sucks. That the hookshot cave can have the hookshot in it. And that's because this lore item down here... Oh, by the way... Bonk is a realistic thing. Question is, how you get over there? You do this. And then you do this. Oh! And then you fail. So you do double bonk. Empty bottle. Okay. And we know what's on top. On top is nothing. So we're just going to jump down here. And then we're just going to check this cave out. See if there's any items in here. To do that disappearing glitch is actually pretty easy. Use the mirror while the block is sliding. That's it. Disappointing. Alright, that's actually not where I wanted to go yet. This is the Death Mountain hype cave. Because there's seven items in this one room by itself. Oh, tempered sword, that's good. Samaria, nice. All right, so I have to go get Quake, which means I have to complete Palace of Darkness, Misery Mire, and Swamp Palace. Screw you, game. All right. Haven't seen a boomerang yet. We're gonna go back up. I don't recall if there's anything over here or not. Oh. That's what's over here. Just another way over here. One long winding tunnel. This is the fabled Super Bunny Cave. Super Bunny is not something that is required for Randomizer, but it's kind of neat just the same. Super Bunny is minor little glitch where you're able to do things as a bunny. It only applies to the one cave because... you're able to fall down, and for some reason, that lets you do things. So while you're in the cave, you can check those two items. Okay. Which one to do first? I don't have the hook shot. Actually, I think hook shot is not required for Misery Mire. I don't need Quake, I just need Ether. Alright, game, let's see what you give me. Normally, you're supposed to have the hook shot, but if you do a bonk, you can have just enough distance. I forgot. I don't have a mirror shield, so I can't deflect that. I was kind of hoping I can avoid hearing this music for this particular run, but not to be. It's okay. There is a possibility I will have to open up the pyramid bond spot. Technically, I actually should check the pyramid and see if there is anything there. Don't have the big key yet, so I can't check the big chest. Which is fine. Normally I don't go this way. What am I doing? Now we check that chest. You are supposed to need the hook shot, but you have just enough time to get over there if you do your dashes correctly. Compass. Okay. I probably don't have to do this long trek. but there's still a possibility of items. This will depend on, I mean, I could have just gone for the boss, but then if he dropped the compass, I'd have to come back here and check the big key chest. So we might as well just get it all done. Map. Alright, that's all three dungeon items. The chances of the boss having an item are actually, they're 100%. And these rooms are where you would need the lantern. If you don't have one, none of this is lit up. I don't have a boomerang. I still don't have the magic powder. So chances of me dying right now are actually pretty good, because all I have is a bee to protect me. So, pro tip, don't die. Helpful, right? So we're going to play it safe. Oh, this boss is still scary, though. We'll eat the leg. One down. Was gonna try hammer dashing. Obviously failed. Alright, let's see what pyramids got. And then off to the palace. I should not have deselected my hammer. Thank you. I can't save and quit here because... Ooh, shovel. Okay. I have not... because I have not defeated Aghanim. And if you don't defeat Aghanim, you never have the option to start here in the Dark World. And yes, because of the randomizer, any items that would replace themselves, like shovel and flute, you can swap between at will if you need to. Nothing's wrong there. Hey. Overwhelmingly disappointed. So, just to make sure I don't screw myself over, I'm going to complete the pendant dungeons now. And I can actually check Sarah Hassela's item. When you earn the green pendant, he gives you another item. And I can do that after I'm done with this one, which I think is red. Red, yep. And then all I have to do are Ice Palace and Turtle Rock. I still have to find the hookshot, though. I think I'm getting ahead of myself here. This is not the optimal path, but that's just because of randomizer. Normally I would go inside that middle door. And I would check the big key spot. My kingdom for a net. Really? What was I off by? 7 pixels, maybe? Ice Rod. That means Turtle Rock, once I open it up, is now completable. I can't check Turtle Rock yet because I need Quake. That's okay. That's what we're doing here. Screw you, Octo. I was gonna say, did I overshoot it? This room is one of a few that are in complete darkness if you do not have the torch. You. Bomb upgrade. All right, this might be a dungeon item. Sad. All right, let's do Mimic Room. Let's be a moron and go the wrong way. I'm not where I thought I was. Map. Arrows. I did not know those were there. If you have the fire rod, you can light one of those up. At least get some light in here while you get those two chests. Kinesimali is so handy. This is the mimic room I thought I was going into. Fail. Wow, you've actually been pretty nice. Okay, let's see what Serengeti gives us. I already cleaned out his room. Okay. Not what I was hoping for, but okay. Alright, after swamp, we'll do ice, and then we'll see what our options are. Because obviously I still have to go to Turtle Rock, but... well, I actually don't need the hookshot to complete Turtle Rock. I do need the hookshot if I want to complete this, though. So either it's going to give it to me in here, or it's going to be in the Swamp Palace, or the Ice Palace. So this is going to be interesting. Come on, be an item. And it probably did that because of the pendants being required. Which means something else could potentially be in this dungeon. This means Turtle Rock will... I mean, it wasn't going to pose an issue in the first place, but... this just solidifies it. So, we are in go mode. Go mode. Wow, what are you doing, Link? Bombs. All right. What you don't want to do is open that up yet, because there is a key under that skull. You don't want to do what I did. If you should happen to do that, though, You will have to completely exit the dungeon and then move a screen away from the Swamp Palace to reset the water. You know, just do something else. I never move the water. I am stupid. I swear I know how to play this game. I still have to check for the boss key, or the big key. This item is potentially useless. Yeah, it's definitely useless. There is no item that the game can give me now in here. However, we will be right in front of it, so we will check this. But we do not have to check any more chests in this dungeon. I mean, even the boomerang is useless at this point. We don't need it. Nice. One cycle. That's all three. This probably is not the fastest way to the Master Sword pedestal. That's okay. scare him away with my bonk. Unbelievable that I had to get the pendants. Stupid Quake Medallion. Oh well, it's fine. But it just means that this... I just gotta check the chests in this dungeon now. Originally, you're supposed to find the blue male in here. We'll see if I can line this up. I got it. First time I've ever gotten that. Fourth time I've tried. Thank you, Stafflos. Guess who doesn't know how to do bomb jumps? Me! So unfortunately, we have to do this the long and hard way. Which is fine. It would be awesome if I can get the big key right here. Thank you, game. Third seed in a row where that chest has been a small key. Ah, stupid anti-fairies. Okay. Aren't ice physics fun? Oh, magic powder, nice. That's handy. don't usually get over that quickly. Those jellies like to play target practice. I mean, technically, I probably don't have to check this. Key. Okay. Yeah. Let's finish the dungeon. I don't even know why I was checking these items. It's probably just a force of habit. It's funny how that floor just decides it doesn't want to be broken anymore. Really, game? Why am I pulling on that? I know it doesn't do anything. Nice. Nice kill. Okay, game. I'm missing 7 hearts. Thought for sure I got it. Still didn't get it. What is this, my 4th time over here? Oh, game. Alright, let's do this. Now, I'm kind of curious about something. Every single seed I've played, this chest here has been a key. Is this a rigged key, or is that just the way it's been? Okay, that's just the way it's been. Oh. I need a couple of regular keys, though, so we will go this way. That sucks. I don't think I have enough time. I'm gonna have the same problem. So let's just reset the state of the room. There. Not ultra useful for that cane, but it's got some situational uses. That room up there is useless and a trap. Don't go in there. I need magic. I just realized I don't have a boomerang to get over there, and Hookshot will just cling to it. Oh, those balls hurt. Those balls hurt. Magic? Nope. That's fine. I did not think that part out. I wonder what's in that chest. Oh well. I'm gonna get a full magic refill before the Tranex fight. Yeah, that's where I gotta go. Thank you. There's a bunch of treasures down there, but we don't need to check those. That's not the full magic refill I was talking about. We'll do the ice side first. Just because it likes to ice the platform, and I'm not fast enough. You're not very random there, boss. Alright, so we just passed 210. We're coming up on 211. This is going to be my fastest seed ever. But, you know, Ganon's Tower can still be a thing. I thought about checking the Hookshot Cave, but I'm like, eh. The only thing that could be a benefit is the butterfly net, which I could find in Ganon's Tower because there's 27 treasure chests in here. Let's see how badly I get trolled. We're just gonna see what this treasure chest is. Well, that'll cause a little too much lag. Alright, that's three so far. Couldn't get that lucky. Of course we couldn't get that lucky. Alright, we're on 7. Eight. Extra keys help. And Boomerang is literally situational at this point. Nine. Ten, 11, 12, 13, there's a possibility it's still buried on the right side of the tower. We'll know for sure after the Armos fight. Nice little shortcut. Of course. Okay, that's fine. Because I can do this. So if you said 14 chests, you guessed correctly. Get over here. It sucks when you don't have the mirror shield. I am never selecting the correct item. Intended strats. Only major item I'm missing. Well, there's two, but magic cape and butterfly net. Gauntlet can always prove to be a challenge. I'm only missing one heart, and I still don't have the several arrows. Now, I've never done silverless before. And I don't have any fairies as backup. Oh, I should have actually gone to the witch's shop. That's okay. I'm gonna stock up on potions. Wow, instead of getting one, or instead of getting three, it got one. Really? What did it hit? of course. Alright, silver arrows are likely in here. Actually, they could be in the ice palace too, because I didn't really finish checking that out, but... And Fat Fairy could also have them. Hey, Aghanim! Really? Terrible Aghanim placement. I want a couple fairies. Just because I don't trust myself with the silverless strats. I have three bottles, I believe. If not, I'll fill up. If I don't have three, I'll just fill up here. Okay. I'm going gonna need this. Actually, hookshot. For invincibility purposes. And for fairy catching. You know, even with red mail, you're still taking a lot of damage. Where did that last hit come from? Wow, that sucks. Really? Turtle Rock? Huh. There were like two chests in there that I didn't check. That was probably the one chest. Yeah, that was probably in the one chest. No, I'm not going to go back for him. That would be silly. Really? Alright, silver arrows were in Turtle Rock. In the one chest I didn't check. I don't want to be up here. Let's see if we can get this. We get a lot of magic to work with, which is good. That's one. Oh, missing is bad. New plan. So I'm pretty sure I can get this. Oh, wow. That was a waste of money. Because I've got to refill on that. Should have bought green first. Oh, well. Oh, well. Alright, I have not defeated Sir Ag. So we're gonna enter from down here. All right, there will be no tanking. I have one fairy to work with. Ah, what are you doing? Oh, I didn't get it. Dang. I'm just better at falling at this point. You have to refill magic. Magic and fairy. Really? My timing stinks. Sit still, you little punk. Damn, I should not have done that. At least the silverless strats are. It's definitely feasible for me. Yeah, where was that drop a minute ago? Oh. That's fine. Have to practice this anyway. At least we're getting double hits. Damn. I think we're just going to cut our losses with that. Maybe I should be using torch or lantern to make sure. Because you really don't have that good of a window. I need magic. Well, let's see if this still works. That's... Save them frames. Wow, Ganon, you're just in the worst spot. No, I didn't, because I'm dumb. Lure him, hit him. That's all I gotta do. Oh, that would have been so nice. Too early. We got him! I was gonna try healing first, but I guess the menu's disabled. You could fall, though. if you wanted to. You have ended the domination of Dr. Willy. I like that. Woohoo! 2 hours, 45 minutes. Okay, so aside from Ganon taking 25 minutes, that was actually the fastest seed I've ever managed to complete. And I'm kind of glad about that. Vultures rule the desert. Of course they do. What else would they do? Bully makes a friend. Aww. He's not really your uncle. Your face for sale. Nice way of saying the mirror, but okay. Fungus for life. Yeah. Two wood choppers. Nice. Boy explodes again. Oh yeah, he gave they gave bombs. That's the reference to I'm your Venus, I'm your fire, your desire. It's always some lyrics from that song regarding that particular fairy. Fire starting kid. Which is accurate. Lost old man. The wavy coin? Curse you. Woohoo. Come on, let's get to the stuff that's important. Come on, let's get to the rest of the stuff that's important. I apologize for the noise, by the way. It has to do somewhat with using line-in to capture audio instead of the audio directly on the capture card. 132 out of 60, or 160, okay. So I missed 50 spots. Missed 3 capacity upgrades and 5 heart pieces. Yeah, it turns out Aghanim's Tower was not needed. I missed half the chests in Turtle Rock. Nice. 41 box? One save and quit, no deaths. I figured I was going to save and quit more than I did. Surprised I didn't. About 13 minutes worth of lag, okay. 2:45:03, and my time was 2:45:33. Not bad. That's still my fastest seed. I mean, Ganon obviously could have gone a lot better. I should be able to get Silver Arrow less strats more often. All right, that's going to do it. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.